Next we have discussed exercise 3.1, first question. Second question I have given you homework. Now discuss the third question. Here, what is the third question given here? You need to draw the parallelogram with the given measurements. So, which parallelogram you need to draw? You need to draw the parallelogram PQRS. So, here, parallelogram. PQRS. You need to draw the parallelogram and here the given measurements. What are the given measurements here? Width PQ. The length of PQ, it is given as 4.5 centimeters. And the length of QR, which is 3 centimeters. And they have given the angle, which is PQR, is equal to 60 degrees. By using these measurements, you need to draw the parallelogram. So here, before drawing the parallelogram, you need to know what are the properties of the parallelogram. We have already discussed in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, and by based on that property, we are going to draw the quadrilateral now. Because here, in this exercise, we already discussed if you have given four sides and one angle, we are drawing the parallelogram. Here, they have given only two sides because you know that the opposite sides are equal, so we got the other two sides also. So clearly we have given here four sides and one angle. Now before drawing to this one, you need to draw the rough sketch. So draw the rough sketch PQR. Here, what is the angle given here? Q angle given. What is the angle given, which is Q? So you need to take Q in the base. So I am taking here PQ as the base here. What is the length of PQ given here, which is 4.5. Now, at point Q, you need to draw an angle of 60 degrees. So here, draw an angle of 60 degrees. This is nothing but, which parallelogram we are drawing here? PQRS. So, it will be P, Q and this should be R and here somewhere you will get S. Now, this parallelogram you need to draw here. Now write the measurements what we know here. You know the length of PQ, which is 4.5, and the length of QR, which is 3 centimeters, and they have given the angle, which is Q, which is 60 degrees. So we have written all the measurements what is given here, and we don't know these two measurements. But in the question they have given that it is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. That means if this is 4.5, what should be this length? This must be equal to 4.5 because this length and this length is equal. Similarly here, what is this length, which is 3? So it must be equal to 3 because these two sides are equal. So we know here the 4 sides and 1 angle. Now you can draw the parallelogram. Let us draw the parallelogram. Now what we need to do, we need to take a length of 4.5 centimeters. So let us take here 4.5. So you know that in between 4 and 5, in the middle you will have a dark line that will be 4.5. So, take a length of 4.5. So, this is the length of 4.5. So, PQ, which is 4.5. So, after that what we need to draw? We need to draw an angle of 60 degrees with the help of the protractor. So here, draw an angle of 60 degrees. Before that, this vertex point and this arrow should coincide with each other, such that we need to keep this protractor. So here, keep this protractor like this. Now, you need to draw here 60 degrees. You know that if you draw the straight line, it will be 90 degrees. So, 90 degrees above this, you will get the obtuse angle. Since it is an acute angle, it will be here somewhere. This is 90, 80, 70 and 60. So, at 60, keep one dot here and join this dot and this vertex Q. So, we have drawn an angle of 60 degrees now. So, let us mark here this angle. How much this angle, which is 60 degrees. Now, again at this point you need to make an arc of 3 cm with the help of your compass. Now, take the length of 3 cm with your compass. So, this is 3, you need to keep it here and 3 cm. Clearly you can observe that these opposite sides are equal. So here how much this is? This is 3, right? So we have, I have made an arc of 3 cm and this length, and here this length must be equal because you know that opposite sides are equal. So at the point we also make an arc of 3 cm. This is 3 and this is also 3. And after that you know that this length and this length is same. If this is 4.5, this must be equal to 4.5. So I am measuring this one. I already took this one as 4.5. So this is 4.5. Now at this point you need to make an arc of 4.5 so that here you get an intersection point. Now here at this point make an arc of 4.5. Clearly here we got an intersection point. Now you can join those intersection points with the help of your scale. So here mark this intersection point like this and join this one. Okay, and after that you need to join this two points. So join this one. So P, Q, R and S. So we have drawn a parallelogram by the given measurements. Now let us draw the measurements. Let us write the measurements here. This is 3 cm. If this is 3, this must be equal to 3. And if this is 4.5, this must be equal to 4.5. So by using these measurements, we have drawn a parallelogram PQR. So what we have done here? First we have drawn a line segment PQ of length 4.5, and at point 2 we have drawn an angle of 60 degrees. And similarly at point 2 we have made an arc of 3 cm. Since these two line segments are equal, and again at this point we have made an arc so that we got an intersection point and we have joined this one. And before session I did not detail the steps of construction, just orally I have written, and for this I am writing here. So how do you write the steps of construction here? And for the remaining problems you can write it in the same way, the steps of construction. So first what we have done here, we have drawn a line segment PQ of length 4.5. So write it here, draw a line segment PQ is equal to 4.5 cm. So write here, draw a line segment of length PQ is equal to 4.5 cm. Now what is the second point? At where it is to draw an arc of 60 degrees. So write it here, or from vertex Q, draw an angle of 60 degrees. Right? We have drawn this one, and similarly go to the third point here. From vertex Q, draw an arc of 3 cm and mark it as an arc. So here write the next step, which is from vertex Q, draw an arc of 3 cm radius, or draw an arc of 3 cm and mark as an arc, and mark it as arc. So what is the next step? The fourth step. So what we have done, what is the next step here? At vertex R, we have made an arc of 4.5 cm. So write it here, and similarly at vertex 2 we have made an arc of 3 cm. I am writing it in both these in one point. And how I write it here? At points P and R I have made an arc of 4.5 and 3 cm respectively. So write it here, at R from vertex, you can write it anything, from vertex R and P, make an arc of, at vertex R, how much the angle we have to be, how much the centimeters we took, 4.5, and from vertex P, which is 3 cm. 4.5 centimeters and 3 centimeters respectively. Otherwise, you can write it in two steps. From vertex R, make an arc of 4.5 centimeters, and the next step from vertex P, make an arc of 3 centimeters. Or we can combine both and write it. And after that, write it here and. Mark the intersection point, and after making an arc here and after making an arc here, we got an intersection point, right? And this intersection point we have written, and we name this one as S. So write it here and mark the intersection point as S. And after that, what is our next step? We have joined RS and we have joined PS. So write it here, the next point, join RS, join R and S and P and S. So what is the next point? So the next one, after joining these are points, we got a parallelogram PQRS. Therefore, the required parallelogram obtained is PQRS. So this is the process. After first you need to draw the rough sketch, and after that you need to draw the parallelogram based on the question, and after that you need to write the steps of construction. So here this problem is completed. Now see the next problem, how to construct. From the next problem one more, just already I will say how to write the steps of construction.
What is the name given for these numbers? Math.
So here, write this is M. So M A T H man. You need to write in a proper order. So you need to construct this one with the help of your geometrical instrument. So what we need to do? We need to draw a line segment of length 4 centimeters first. So here, draw a line segment which is of length 4 centimeters. So draw it here 4 centimeters. This is 4 centimeters. So mark it as AB. The length of AB it is given as 4 centimeters. Now at point A you need to make an angle of 120 degrees with the help of the protractor. So take your protractor and this point, this vertex A and this arrow mark to coincide with each other. So that you need to keep the protractor. So keep the protractor like this. And here you know that this is 90 degrees and this is 100, 110 and 120. Right? So keep it here at 120. Keep one dot. Now join this dot and the point A. This is nothing but 120 degrees. And now you know that each side is equal to the 4 centimeters in a rhombus. Now with the help of your compass, you need to make an arc of 4 centimeters. So here you know that this is 4, measure this length as 4. Now at this point, draw an arc of 4 centimeters. And similarly, the rhombus, all sides are equal. And similarly, at this point, make an arc of 4 centimeters. And at this point also, make an arc of 4 centimeters. So since all sides are equal, at each vertex I have drawn an arc of 4 centimeters. First I have drawn here 4 centimeters and at this point I have made an arc of 4 centimeters and again at this point I have made an arc of 4 centimeters and at this point I have made an arc of 4 centimeters. Now we got an intersection point. At this intersection point we can join these lines. So here we got it here one intersection point. Now you need to join that intersection point here. And similarly here you got one intersection point. This is the intersection point. And now you need to join these two points here. So we have constructed a rhombus. And now write the measurements here. This is 4 and this is 4 and this is also 4. Now what is the rhombus we have drawn, which is mat? So write it here. M-A-T-H. This is our required rhombus. So how we have constructed, if you know the properties of the quadrilateral, then you can easily construct the given quadrilateral. Since here they have given only one length and you know that in a rhombus all sides are equal. So we have drawn here 4 centimeters. At this point we have drawn an angle of 120 degrees and we have drawn each length as 4 centimeters so that we got here the rhombus. Now you can write the steps of construction. Orally I am saying here how to write. First step, draw a line segment of length 4 centimeters. And the second step, at vertex A, draw an angle of 120 degrees. And similarly, the third step, at vertex A, draw an arc of 4 centimeters and mark the intersection point as M. And at vertex M, draw an arc of 4 centimeters and vertex B, draw an arc of 4 centimeters and mark the intersection point as H. Now join T and H and M and H. Now the last point, the required rhombus is nothing but MATH. Like this you need to write the steps of construction. In the next session we are going to solve the remaining problems. And from this session is completed.